Hey, what's up, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Ines Alea from toleratedcinematics.com, and today it's another Motion Graphic Mondays. I'm going to be showing you how to create a nice glitch stutter effect in Adobe Premiere Pro right after this. Alright, so it's a really simple technique that I'm going to be showing you today. We're going to take a look on how to use expressions to automate our stutter effect in Adobe Premiere Pro. It's a really simple technique that anyone can learn, whether you're a beginner or an expert. I myself didn't know this technique for a long time, but I was looking into making my introduction that you just saw, and I used this technique in there to make it as simple as possible, because I didn't want to use many layers, I didn't want to use keyframes, I just wanted to automate this effect, and I was sure it was possible, so I did some research and came with this solution. So as you know, I used that technique in my intro, also in the lower thirds, which by the way we also sell on our website. So if you're interested in that template or for the lower thirds, which you see right here, you can go ahead and get that on our website, and it helps to support the channel. Alright, so without further ado, let's jump into Adobe After Effects and get started. Alright, so here I have the template open, which you can get on our website. As you can see, it looks really cool. So what I will be doing here is just show you very quickly what the final result would look like. So right here I have a cross for example, so let's go and look one up. A language, let's solo this for now and just preview it. So now what I have here is actually a line, it's one layer, and without any keyframes. You can actually see that I have just a time remap keyframe, that's all I have. I have no position keyframes, no opacity keyframes, no movement keyframes, no opacity keyframes or whatsoever, and I have no effects applied except for the color. But yet it does move all over the place, and it looks some kind of glitchy kind of effect, which is really cool to do. If I open up that composition, all I've done is I used a fractal noise here, and yeah, you can see that I created something like this. So what I have done to actually move this all over the place is really simple and will be will be showed right now. Okay, so the first thing what I will do is create a new composition. By the way, also a very important tip, even though you want to create everything yourself, I never bought a template when I started out, because I was like, I want to create it myself, I want to learn how I do it. But sometimes it's actually good to buy a template, and then I realized that if I bought a template that I could kind of backwards engineer it and then learn from that template, so then I would recreate it myself. But actually buying templates is not just to save time, it's also to learn a lot about that, how that project was made, so you can actually go ahead, look which effects were applied, how the effects were applied, and just get some smarter by backwards engineering a template someone else created. So that's a small tip I want to give you guys. I never saw it like that, but yeah, if you want to learn After Effects, sometimes it's good to look into a project from someone else. Okay, so here we are. I have a timeline, and actually I will change my FPS to 24, and you'll see later why. So right here I will set the time to something like 10 seconds, and I will rename this to tutorial example. Okay, there we go, click OK. So the first way that I use to do these kind of things, let's say we have like a little square and we want to move it all over the place, what I would do is actually move a few frames, Control Shift D, or go to edit and split the layer, and I would trim it down a little bit and then like move it over here a few frames further. I would move it over here another few frames, I would move it here, and also maybe fade it off or something, and then you would have something like this, which looks really cool and very glitchy. But it takes a lot of effort to really keep doing this over and over again, and maybe also like move the scale. You could also go and jump into these kind of features, maybe also duplicate it again, split the layer, and maybe lower the opacity just a touch, and you would have something like this, which is very glitchy. It looks great, but it takes a lot of time, and also it's not organized, because you would see like a ton of layers in your timeline and it just doesn't look clean, and I love projects that look clean. So what I will do is delete everything and just show you the technique that I have found to do this all in just a simple expression. So what we have here, I will first just center my anchor point right here, there we go. Okay, so I have my square, and let's make it a little bit bigger and position it right here. So what you could do is go to the position keyframe and move it on like this. You could go and move it one frame further and move it like this, and you would have something like this. Also very cool, also a lot of time, again, keyframes. So I will hold Alt and click on the stopwatch for the position, and then you can write something like wiggle, open parentheses, and like, let's say 4 times a second or maybe 8 times a second. I want to move it 600 pixels over my composition, or even like 1000, because actually 1000 pixels is, if you look at the composition settings, we have a width of 1920, so that's not even the entire width of our composition. So it's not going to move all the way on the edge here, but it's going to move up and down, and it's going to get off screen sometimes. So let's click OK and see what that will do. So as you can see, it's actually not touching the edges everywhere. So what I will do is actually increase this number a little bit more, like 500. So now 1500 pixels, it can move randomly. Of course, because it's actually in the center, it can move 1500 to the left and 1500 to the right, which means it's over 3000, which means it will actually cover the entire composition here. So now we have something like this. Okay, maybe this is a little bit too fast. So what I will do is lower this to something like 3 times a second. Or maybe even 1 time a second. Okay, so really cool, the wiggle. Everyone would have thought about this. Okay, I can just add a wiggle and I have the movement all over the place. The only problem here is that it's smooth. It's just super smooth. You actually see the square moving. And I didn't want that. I want some kind of, I want a glitched look. I want it to be, to stutter to one location, stay there a few seconds, move to another location, and yeah, just stutter. So what we can do very simple, simply, is just use this expression, but we're going to kind of cut some frames out of it. So what we'll do is actually make this a little bit larger so we can actually see our expression window here. So I will drag this out. Okay, there we go. And on top of the wiggle, what we will write here is actually posterize, or actually with a small caps, posterize with a Z time with a caps T, open the parentheses and write something like 8. And then close it and then point, comma. So right here I wrote 8, and what I will do is actually very simple. You will see that it has some kind of stutter effect right here. And what I will do is just 8 times a second, it's going to update the posterize time, it's going to update the wiggle expression. So it's gonna freeze, and then 8 times a second, it's going to update the value to the wiggle preset. You can also just go like 1, and that's just going to do once a second, it's going to update. And if it's off screen, then you also see that it's not visible anymore. So you could change it to something like 3. So 3 times a second, you will have some kind of stutter effect, which is pretty cool. You can also go to the opacity and just copy the settings. So copy the setting, go to T, Alt click on stopwatch for the opacity and paste these expressions. But instead of 1000, we'll just change it to 100. So it's going to wiggle 100 in the opacity here. So here we have a smaller value. Let's say you want to also change the size here of the square to also randomly kind of stutter. We'll go and hold Alt and click on the stopwatch for scale. And here we'll also just copy our and paste our settings right here. So very easy. Let's open that up and also change it to something like 180 in the wiggle, because yeah, 1500 is just too much. And now we'll have something like this. You can also go maybe 300. Okay, cool. So that's a very fun technique that you can use to do this kind of effect. You can also go into your shape and like make a cross. So maybe you can create a new composition, make it 500 by 500, click OK. We'll easily create a cross here. So maybe a solid, click OK, and then just make it smaller like this. Duplicate it and then just rotate this solid. So now we have a nice cross here. Let's go to our tutorial example and just add the cross to our composition. Maybe rotate it 45 degrees and we have something like this. And now we can just copy all these settings. So we have scale that we have animated, we have T that we, opacity that we have animated, and the position. So I actually just did this by pressing T on the keyboard, holding shift and press S on the keyboard to add scale, hold shift and press P on the keyboard to add a position. So all I'll do is just select all of these, holding control, and then copy these settings by holding control and C and pressing C, and then click on the composition, just paste all these settings and just delete this. And now we would have something like this. And of course the scale is gonna look terrible because now we don't have a nice uniform scaling going on. So what we can do is open these settings and just easily, before the wiggle, we're going to open the brackets, and after the wiggle, we're going to say 0, comma, and then again, copy the wiggle. So that's just the end. Paste it behind the comma, and then again, 0, and close the brackets. So now it will have some uniform scaling going on. And if you want the smaller cross, you just go over here, click on the cross, and make it smaller. Okay, so this seems about right. We can also lower the scale a little bit like this, and we have a nice cross just jumping on and off on our screen, and it looks kind of glitchy. All right, so this is a very simple technique that you can apply to your projects, to any kind of value within After Effects. Yeah, just to make it look like a glitchy kind of movement. So this is a really fun technique that I found that makes it so clean to work in your timeline. You have no extra layers, you have no extra keyframes, you just write the code with a wiggle and the post-rise time on top of it, and that will get you these results. So. Alright, so that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give this video a like. Also subscribe to the channel for more, and definitely check out our website. We have a bunch to offer for filmmakers and motion graphics artists, and if you buy something, it helps to support the channel. I'll see you in the next one, and goodbye.